Welcome to this video about regional citrate anticoagulation in extracorporeal blood circuits. During treatment in citrate calcium continuous veno-venous hemodialysis therapy mode, or short CKRCVVHD, blood is withdrawn from the patient. It is treated outside the human body and returned to the patient with the help of the CRRT device. The actual dialysis happens in the hemofilter before the blood is given back to the patient. Without anticoagulation, blood clotting could occur, especially in the hemofilter. Citrate anticoagulation using CKAR reduces the likelihood of such clotting. Calcium ions are an important component of the physiological coagulation cascade in blood. The absence of free ionized calcium can disrupt this complex cascade. For this reason, sodium citrate 4% is added to the blood in the extracorporeal circuit right at the beginning. This leads to the formation of calcium citrate complexes. The resulting reduction of the concentration of free ionized calcium results in less clotting of the blood. This is a prerequisite for the intended CRRT effect to occur undisturbed at the hemofilter, the removal of fluid and toxins. Besides, a relevant part of the calcium citrate complexes is removed here. Thus, calcium must be substituted before the filtered blood returns to the patient. This is necessary to prevent systemic hypocalcemia. It happens by adding calcium chloride to the return line of the dialysis machine, which is also important to restore the components of the coagulation cascade. Some of the calcium citrate complexes are still present in the blood after the filtration process. In FMC acute dialysis machines, the citrate calcium anticoagulation is controlled via elaborate software. This also controls the coupling between the multiple pumps for matching flows of the different solutions. All processes can be monitored and individual adjustments can be made via the user interface.